So, something recently has been leaked in the coaster community about Kings Island, and it's a picture of Fred Grubb, the owner of Rocky Mountain Construction. Now, in this video, we're going to be discussing what the heck this means, why he's there, what he could be doing, and oh my gosh, what's happening with Kings Island in the future. Let's get started. So, before I get into this, whoever took this picture and owns the picture, and also whoever wrote this post, could you please let me know if it's yours so I can give you the proper credit in the description? Because I have no idea whose this is. I just found it off of Instagram from many screenshots. Anyway, look who has been sniffing around Kings Island Racer yesterday. Fred Grubb from RMC. Very interesting. What does the sister park have in store? Possibly another Twisted Colossus style coaster like at Magic Mountain? Or an actual RMC racing coaster? Ah, well, you see, if I would actually read, I would see that this photo was taken by Jeff Koth and Brendan Carey. Brendan Carey. So go follow them on their social medias if you can find them. Thank you guys for taking this awesome photo. And if this is your post that I screenshotted, please let me know still as well so I can give you credit for that as well. Because free shoutouts are cool, man. So when we see Fred Grubb walking around next to Racer, I think of a few things. I either think T-Rex, Raptor, which is probably not likely, or RMC Racer. The two most likely are RMC Racer or a T-Rex. So one thing I'm thinking with the RMC T-Rex is I'm pretty sure Cedar Fair knows that this type of ride is called a T-Rex. And Dinosaurs Alive was just cleared out. Giga fanboys are getting mad at me, but maybe they'll put the T-Rex over there. If they decided to go with the T-Rex, I think it'd be pretty cool because they could just theme it to dinosaurs and it's cool, you know? It's like the model of the ride and matches the area it's in. It's just pretty cool. But then all the Giga fanboys get mad. But what if it is a Giga? That's the other question. Because if Cedar Fair were to make this a Giga for Kings Island, it would be different than any of the other four Gigas in the Cedar Fair chain. And I think that is a very strong move. It is also very good for RMC because RMC is once again putting another style out there. Because apparently this T-Rex track is capable of anything. Like, it could do anything B&M can do, it can do anything other RMCs can do. So I think it would be really cool if it was a Giga. If not, probably more like a Blitzy looking thing, like in this picture here, which someone made on YouTube. Now the other possibility, which I hope isn't true, would be RMC Racer. Now it's always fun to think about how amazing an RMC Racer would be, which as you can see here, I got pretty creative, and this is almost a year ago when I made this, and I've gotten way better now, so imagine what RMC could even do. Like, geez, it'd be amazing. But Racer is Racer, it's a classic. It's an ace landmark. It's so historic. Tearing down Racer would be like tearing down the Beast or tearing down Magnum or RMCing it. It's basically tearing it down. And I just can't imagine Coney Mall without the Racer being there. I mean, yeah, it would still kind of be there, but it wouldn't feel right. And I just, it's also just my childhood, and it's so many other people. It plays a huge role in so many people's lives. And I know they did that with Colossus at Six Flags, but like, that's Six Flags. Cedar Fair somewhat actually kind of cares. Somewhat. But yeah, I think an RMC would be pretty good. I think it would probably be beneficial for the park. They get good attendance and all that. Bring life into Coney Mall, but it just wouldn't feel like Coney Mall. It'd just be the Vortex and just RMC here. I think the T-Rex would be much better, honestly. And one last thing before we finish. I think everyone's also jumping to conclusions too much. How do they know that Cedar Fair is just not showing Mr. Grubb around? I mean, they just started working together. They might have a contract or whatever, like they used to with B&M, or Cedar Fair used to do that with B&M and some other companies. How do you know they're just not showing him around? Like, oh, look at our great parks, you know? Look at all these. Maybe he's looking around for future stuff. I don't know. Maybe he's just having fun. I mean, you guys are jumping to these conclusions. I mean, he can't even visit a park without you guys, like, he's RMCing it. Just chill out. Like, for real. But yeah, I'm just doing my job here. You guys are all freaking out over this, so I was just reporting on it, I guess. Yeah. That's my thoughts on it, discussing the possibilities of what I think could happen. But honestly, I think he's just chilling, just looking around Cedar Fair parks. I wouldn't be surprised if you see him in another Cedar Fair park here soon. So, yeah, if we see him in another Cedar Fair park anytime soon, I think he's just going looking around. But I don't really know. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, all that usual crap. I'll be at Kings Island in a little more than a week, actually. Yeah, a little more than a week. So, yeah, oof. I'll be there to do stuff on this subject. Thanks, guys, for watching. As always, ride on.